Hello students, have a lovely day to all of you. Welcome to Easy Learning Channel. In this presentation, we are going to study about measurement of atmospheric pressure and a weather forecast. Let us study. First is instrument used to measure atmospheric pressure. Barometer is used to measure air pressure or atmospheric pressure. There are three types of barometer: simple barometer, aneroid barometer, and a 14 barometer. This is a picture of aneroid barometer, and this is a picture of simple barometer. One by one, we will discuss. First, let us discuss who discovered barometer. In 1643, Evangelista Torricelli invented the barometer in laboratory. Simple barometer. It consists of two parts: a glass tube of about 1 meter length is filled with a pure and a dry mercury, and it is inverted in a bowl of mercury only. That means inside glass tube also mercury, in bowl also mercury. And Torricelli observed that the mercury falls by a few centimeters of height, creating an empty space above the level of mercury. And he observed that level of mercury in the tube is 760 millimeter above the level of mercury. What is the reason behind that? Because the pressure from outside atmosphere, that is the pressure of the air molecule, pushed the mercury up into the glass tube. That's why up to a certain level it falls down. Because of atmospheric pressure, it is maintaining a height inside the glass tube, and this height is called a barometric height. This word is very important. We will discuss this word while discussing about weather forecasting. And as atmospheric pressure increases from outside, the mercury in the tube also rises up. And sea level pressure is considered as reference point. At the sea level, the height of the mercury column rises is 760 millimeter or 76 centimeter, and creating a vacuum above the mercury column. That vacuum is called a Torricellian vacuum. And another interesting fact is Torricelli is the first scientist who is able to create a vacuum in laboratory. And one atmospheric pressure means at sea level equal to 76 centimeter mercury height. That is a barometric height. This height is barometric height. Above this height, it is leaving a vacuum, that is Torricellian vacuum that we already discussed. Next is 14 barometer. 14 barometer is a protected form of simple barometer. The glass tube and a mercury ball and all protected inside a brass tube, metallic brass tube. And another important point is a vernier scale is attached. Vernier scale means from 14 barometer more accurate reading of atmospheric pressure we can measure. That means compared to simple barometer, 14 barometer will give more accurate reading of atmospheric pressure. That means for small variation of atmospheric pressure also 14 barometer will give the measurement. And 14 barometer is having screw to adjust mercury level also, screw to adjust vernier scale also. And the next is aneroid barometer. It is a inside picture of aneroid barometer, inner part of aneroid barometer. It contains a metal chamber connected to a dial. And a metal chamber is also called a sealed aneroid cell. That means aneroid means without liquid. In aneroid barometer, no liquid is used. It is working as if air pressure is applied on the metal chamber, it contracts or expands. If air pressure is more, metal chamber expands, and according to that, this needle will move left and right, showing the air pressure high or low. That is the working of aneroid barometer, and this is a pressure indicator. And the advantage of aneroid barometer is it is portable. It can easily move from one place to another place, and no prior adjustment is needed before reading. Direct reading we can take, and no liquid is using inside the aneroid barometer. That's all about the instrument used to measure atmospheric pressure, simple barometer, 14 barometer, and aneroid barometer. Next is variation in atmospheric pressure with altitude. Measurement how to take we already discussed. Now variation in atmospheric pressure with the altitude. Let us discuss using a graph. In x-axis, height above the sea level is marked, and in y-axis, atmospheric pressure in centimeter of mercury is marked. And it is a barometric height, that is atmospheric pressure. And at 0 kilometer, that is the sea level, maximum atmospheric pressure, that is 76 centimeter of mercury. And height is increasing from 0 to 6 means atmospheric pressure is decreasing to 45 centimeter of mercury. Again height is increasing, 12 kilometer means 30 centimeter of mercury. And height is increasing, as height is increasing, atmospheric pressure is decreasing. That means atmospheric pressure is inversely proportional to height above the sea level. One is decreasing, other is increasing. One is increasing, other is decreasing. That is inversely proportional. And next is weather forecasting. Weather forecasting depends on two factors: change in temperature and the amount of water vapor present in air. Change in temperature means temperature increases or decreases. Temperature, if temperature increasing, warm air it is. That means air molecule will move with a more energy, and a volume increases and a density decreases. That means air molecule becomes more lighter. More lighter means it rises up, so low pressure. Lighter molecule means low pressure. And cool air means cool air temperature decreasing, so density increasing. That means heavier air particles. So it sinks down. It sinks down, but hot air rises up. And look at this picture. Which of the picture is low pressure? Of course, B is low pressure, because hot air rises up, leaving low pressure area. And this picture A is a high pressure area, cold air sinks down. So it from high pressure to low pressure area, wind travels. And next we are going to compare the barometric height and weather forecast. Barometric height means that is atmospheric pressure. Barometric height, in the first case, barometric height suddenly falls. Suddenly falls means the pressure at that place has suddenly decreased. Sudden decrease means a hot air, a sudden increase in temperature. So hot air rises up. So from high pressure area to low pressure area, wind travels. So storm or cyclone creates when there is a sudden fall in atmospheric pressure or barometric height. Now the second case is gradually falls. Gradually falls means increase in moisture in the atmosphere. Increase in moisture means increase in the amount of water vapor. That is because of vaporization, and vaporization is a slow process, and because vaporization is a slow process, the barometric height also falls slowly, gradually. And after vaporization, what will happen? Water vapors again change back to water, that is condensation, possibility of rain. And third case is sudden rise in barometric height. That means sudden rise in atmospheric pressure. In this case, what is happening? Sudden rise in atmospheric pressure means from high pressure area, flow of air from high pressure area to low pressure areas. That means from high pressure area, wind is traveling. That creates a dry, extremely dry weather in that area. And a sudden movement of wind is happening there. Because of that extremely dry weather, will come in that area. And next is a gradual increase. That means slow increase in the barometric height or atmospheric pressure means dry weather. Dry weather is because of the moisture, decrease in moisture. Decrease in moisture is also a slow process. So slow increase in the barometric height, and it creates a dry weather in that area. And last case, if there is no abrupt change, means barometric height is normal. Means a normal pleasant weather. That's all about this presentation. Hope you all understood the concept about weather forecast and the instrument used to measure atmospheric pressure. Stay connected. I will be uploading more videos. Thank you.